Today, I want to share with you all a photo of myself that I have never showed anyone before. Something that I've never showed my friends nor family because I want you guys to be the first ones to see it. After hours of going through old pictures and albums, here is what I came up with. Sorry if you were expecting something humiliating, like a baby picture or something. But no, that is not the result of bad lighting. It is what it is, a blank canvas. See, I wasn't always the ideal type of person. Back in the day, I flunked math class. Pero oks lang, math lang naman eh. But no, I flunked to the point that I got the floor grade, which is way lower than the passing mark. As a result, I took summer class. Back in the day, I was a professional liar. I used to straight up lie to my teachers and parents' faces alike just so I could skip school that day. And I did this not once, not twice, not even thrice, but several consecutive times. In essence, I was never active in any position or extracurricular activity, nor was I an Albert Einstein. If I were to sum up who I was before in a few words, it would be the following. Introvert. I hate being around crowds. I hate being at the forefront of things. Subjective. I'm one to judge people quickly. If I feel like I don't like you despite not even getting to know you better, probably keep my distance. Your first move, buddy. Passive. I'm cool with things happening around me, no matter its morality. If someone's dying over there, well, somebody else can go take care of him. I don't know CPR, man. And last but not the least, lazy. Fast forward to third year high school, my junior year. I was elected as class president. Let me repeat that. I was elected as class president. How on earth am I supposed to take those traits and all the other dumb stuff I've done in my childhood and put them into the shoes of a leader? The ideal thing to do here would be to take those undesired traits, throw them out the window, make room for ones that actually fit responsibility. It's logical, it's rational, it makes sense. That's what most of us would do, and so that's what I tried doing. Okay, here, let's try fixing this, okay? Introvert, scrap it. A class president has to be an extrovert. He has to be outgoing, easy to talk to, and have fantastic peer relation skills. Duh. Subjective? More like objective. A class president has to see the potential in anyone and everyone at all times. Passive? Fudge no. He has to be active. Initiative should be a part of his core principles. Lazy? Are you kidding me? How are things supposed to work around here if the leader is enjoying a hot fudge sundae on a sunny afternoon? Extrovert, objective, active, diligent. Now that is what I call an ideal class president. About 2 years later, to this very moment, I've been blessed with an encyclopedia of experiences that made me learn quite the exact opposite of what I thought was the best way to change my personality to fit a leadership role. I came up with a model that can give us a clear outline to see as to where we've been and as to where we're headed. That blank canvas that I shared with you all earlier, I'd like to think that it's not just a blank canvas, but also a square sheet of paper. Plain. Pure, untainted, to the point that it almost seems perfect. That's how we all start. What can you do with a square sheet of paper like this? Well, you could draw on it, you could paint on it, but for me personally, I prefer to fold it. I'm a bit biased because that is, after all, my hobby, my avocation, the Japanese art of paper folding, origami. If you follow traditional origami rules, then that would mean using only one square sheet, just like this. No cuts, no glue, no tape. Just pure 100% folding. With those rules, you could produce the classics, which I'm sure you're all familiar with, such as the origami crane, the jumping frog, and the very scandalous paper airplane. I would throw this, but I'm afraid that it might poke someone's eye out, so never mind. Thank you, sir. It doesn't really matter, does it? I fold. Okay, so what? I thought about it. I pondered. Suddenly, I had an epiphany. Origami taught me my first lesson about what change means, contrary to popular belief. Think about it. What's the first thing that comes to your mind when you hear the word change? Answers would usually involve something drastic, such as revolution or new life or something of the like. But here's the thing. In origami, no matter what model you fold, you're still only using that one square sheet. It's not like you folded an origami dog, per se, which only has two front legs, and you had to attach the other two hind legs just to make it look like a normal dog. Change is not always a drastic process. It's a gradual one. Just like how folding takes time, so does trying to adapt to a new responsibility. Just like how origami only uses one square sheet, each and every one of us does so as well. Not in the sense that we are all pieces of paper, because that would be awfully horrifying, but in the sense that there is only one me, and there is only one you. You don't scrap the entire system just because you see there's something wrong with it. You stick with that broken system, and you give it time to improve itself. I took that with me throughout my journey as class president. During the beginnings of my term, I had quite the culture shock, so to speak. It was my first time being in such a position, so of course, I wasn't familiar with the ins and outs of the trade just yet. As such, I came up with a list that I like to call What People Think the Class President Should Do. 1, control the class. 2, control the class. 3, control the class. 4, repeat steps 1-3. Spoiler alert. 1, control the class. 2, control the class. 3, control the class. Repeat steps 1-3. If you happen to screw up on any of these steps, like it matters which step you screw up on, somebody's probably going to call you out for it. Somebody with more gusto. And for good reason. I mean, you're not doing your job, eh? And when that somebody does, everyone's going to turn their heads to look and stare at you. Judgment from all angles ensues, but I don't blame them. I've been part of that group. And I'm sure that everyone here has as well. It's a social phenomenon to be part of the majority, to make the minority feel lost. Only this time, the tables were flipped. I was that minority. Being an introvert and passive, I hesitated a lot to speak up during times when I should have. So, I was forced to sit there and take whatever crap came my way. You could say that I deserved it, and logically speaking, Yeah, I did. But you could also argue that it was only my first time. But not everyone sees that. I learned that change involves working with our weaknesses. Those 4 unideal traits that we scratched out earlier, I didn't want them. I wanted to jump straight to the other end and have those instead so that everyone would see how amazing of a leader I am. But to get to that other end, I first had to work with what I had, my weaknesses. Those innate traits are what allowed me to have my down moments wherein I regretted signing up for this position in the first place. But that's also what allowed me to understand what I should do next time to avoid falling under the feeling of desolation. In origami, this is reflected in what we like to call the pre-creasing stage, wherein we make all the folds necessary to produce whatever model that we're trying to make. For example, if you take the origami crane earlier and unfold it, we're going to get a certain crease pattern, just like so, which will give us all of the pre-creases that we needed to make the crane. Imagine how each fold can actually represent the different experiences and aspects that we have from our day-to-day lives. The list I came up with earlier, it wasn't just about controlling the class. I learned that after weeks and months of getting acquainted with my position, there was also about leading to serve, about developing camaraderie with everyone in the class, including those that I would normally avoid, and generally speaking, being the adhesive that bonds everyone together. That's the pre-creasing stage. During our school would always have this annual school fair, which would sport rides, arcade games, food, of course, and other festivities for all to enjoy. Each section, each class is always in charge of hosting one game booth. So as expected, I had to be the one steering the wheel for my class. We dedicated a session to plan for the event. I was up in front, encouraging and considering the different ideas that people had for our game booth. I had to be careful of how I shot down ideas that I didn't like. I had to make an open and leveled environment. True, all this time I've been trying to be an ideal class president that everybody loves, but towards the end of the session, I made a committee that was going to be in charge of booth construction. At that point, I couldn't help but let my innate characteristics take over. Being subjective, I handpicked people who I knew were going to be up for the job. But then I subconsciously removed somebody's name from the list when I remembered that I had a quota to follow. Let's call him Edwards. I removed Edwards because, knowing him, I thought he would be dead weight to the group. But when he found out what I did, boy, was he pissed off. He started flipping me off, throwing around F-bombs, and just kept repeating how I should stop talking to him. I got our class advisor involved so that the three of us could settle that issue right there and then, because I'm not one to go home without settling something that I've started. At that point, I cried. I cried the most painful and hardest cry that I've ever done in my life in front of my class advisor and in front of Edwards. All the built-up stress from trying to be someone who I'm not exploded out at that very moment, but then that taught me the foremost lesson about change that was imperative for me to learn. Each of these represent opposite sides of a pole. They're all opposites of each other. Through my experiences, I was slowly able to inch toward the opposite end of each pole. But if you put them all together, they would collectively make up my being as a whole. But really, it varies for all of us. Some of us might be rigid at first, but with a little practice can learn to be flexible. Some of us might be timid, but can gradually learn to be daring. Some of us might be down, but there's no other way to go but up. Really, you can put in whatever traits you have or want to have in there, as long as it defines you. The point is, where do they all intersect? Boom, right there, dead in the center. That red dot, that optimum point, is what we're all aiming for. Change is about finding a balance, not an extreme. With balance, we are able to have both good and bad, both success and failure. Sometimes you have to be an introvert to be able to relate with people on a personal level. But at the same time, you have to be an extrovert to be able to have the confidence to do just that. Sometimes you have to be subjective in order to be careful as to who you invest your trust in. But at the same time, you have to be objective in order to be careful and in order to respect everyone's potential. Sometimes you have to be diligent in order to work hard for what you want. But at the same time, you have to be lazy in order to know how to relax. It just so happened that we're talking in the context of being a leader. But there are no good or bad traits, just desired and undesired ones. In retrospect, where have we been? We started with a blank square sheet of paper. We put some folds in. Now, where do we go from here? I don't actually have an answer in specific to that third step, although you would expect there to be some random origami model to fill in that spot. See, in origami, sure, 10, 20 folds can give you your cranes and jumping frogs, but 100 or even 200 plus folds can give you stuff like this. This, or even this. See, thank you. The magic behind this art form is that you can literally fold anything that you could think of. You name it. Animals, insects, humanoids, objects, tessellations, math, science, anything. That is not an overstatement. That is not an exaggeration. No matter what model you fold, the foremost question that still remains to be answered time and time again is, once again, what did you do to that sheet of paper? In the words of Robert Lang, a renowned origami artist, you didn't add to it, you didn't take away from it, you changed it, but it's still the same sheet. Change, giving ourselves time, staying true to who we are by working with our weaknesses and finding that balance, or it make it possible for all of us to have the experiences to improve ourselves as human beings. Thank you very much.